In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, and the virgin's name was Mary. He went in and said to her, "Mary, do not be afraid. You have won God's favor. Listen, you are to conceive and bear a son, and you must name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High." Mary said to the angel, "But how can this come about since I am a virgin?" "The Holy Spirit will come upon you," the angel answered, "and the power of the Most High will cover you with its shadow. And so the child will be holy and will be called the Son of God." "I am the handmaid of the Lord," said Mary. "Let what you have said be done to me."
My soul is longing for your peace, near to you, my God. Lord, you know that my heart is not proud, and my eyes are not lifted from the earth. My soul is longing for your peace, near to you, my God.
Lofty thoughts have never filled my mind, far beyond my sight all ambitious deeds.
My soul is longing for your peace, near to you, my God. In your peace I have maintained my soul. I have kept my heart in your quiet peace. My soul is longing for your peace, near to you, my God. My soul is longing for your peace, near to you, my God. Israel, put all your hope in God. Place your trust in him now and evermore. My soul is longing for your peace, near to you, my God.
Mary set out at that time and went as quickly as she could to a town in the hill country of Judah. She went into Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. Now, as soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She gave a loud cry and said, "Of all women, you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Why should I be honored with a visit from my Lord? For the moment your greeting reached my ears, the child in my womb leapt for joy. Yes, blessed is she who believed that the promise made her by the Lord would be fulfilled."
Rejoice, rejoice, blessed Mary, rejoice. May joy fill your heart. favor with God, and you shall bear a son.
Alleluia,
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 Alleluia. Rejoice, rejoice, blessed Mary.
Now at that time, Caesar Augustus issued a decree for a census of the whole world to be taken. So Joseph set out from the town of Nazareth and travelled to Judea to the town of David called Bethlehem. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them at the inn. When the eighth day came and the child was to be circumcised, they gave him the name Jesus, the name the angel had given before his conception. And when the day came for them to be purified, they took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. Now in Jerusalem there was a man called Simeon. He was an upright and devout man. He looked forward to Israel's comforting, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death until he had set eyes on the Christ of the Lord. Simeon blessed them and said to Mary his mother, "You see this child? He is destined for the fall and rising of many in Israel, destined to be a sign that is rejected, and a sword will pierce your own soul too, so that the secret thoughts of many may be laid bare."
A star.
There was a wedding at Cana in Galilee. The mother of Jesus was there, and Jesus and his disciples had also been invited. When they ran out of wine, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." Jesus said, "Woman, why turn to me? My hour has not come yet." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." There were 6 stone jars standing there, meant for the ablutions that are customary amongst the Jews. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water," and they filled them to the brim. "Draw some out now," he told them, "and take it to the steward." They did this. The steward tasted the water, and it had turned into wine. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. Seeing his mother and the disciple he loved standing near her, Jesus said to his mother, "Woman, this is your son." Then to the disciple he said, "This is your mother." And from that moment, the disciple made a place for her in his home.
Mm-hmm. I say that we are wound with mercy round and round as if with air. The same is Mary, more by name. She, wild web, wondrous robe, mantles the guilty globe. Since God has let disperse her prayers his providence. Nay, more than Alamer, the sweet alms self is her, and men are meant to share her life as life does air.
I'm